Hey there, this is Mike Barkoff of Barking Bands Collectibles. Today I'm going to be telling you kind of my experience with a recording studio that I just bought. Not bad at all, actually, it's a good experience. But just kind of my suggestions for how to start off with a recording studio if you, like I, have never owned one. I was on a budget limit when I got mine. I could only spend about $90, and I got even lower than that. And that's with three XLRs, male to female, input and output, and a USB to HDMI cable, all off of Amazon. I got, I believe, four products. Some of them I ordered multiples of. I got them for $85, and even though they suggested that I actually needed more parts, I haven't had any problems with them, so I'm going to go through them all. So that includes the Behringer Uphoria audio interface, which is about this big. It's the smallest one that they make. But it works perfectly if you're just starting out. And the Neewer, I believe that's how you pronounce it, microphone and its set, which is $31. The Behringer Uphoria was about $25 to $30, I believe. The Neewer was definitely $32, somewhere in that range, $31 to $32, one of the two. And then three male to female input and output XLR cables and the USB to HDMI. So let's go through these. Now, one of my main problems with this whole set is that a lot of the packaging, especially for the microphone, was kind of subpar at best. So I kept everything in the big box that I got, the things that I didn't want to put back in the microphone box because it was just so crazy and all over the place. Here's your instruction guides and all that. The Neewer, most of it isn't actually Japanese, but I think there's an English one right here. I don't really like to read the instructions. I like to play around with my equipment before I read the instructions. And then the audio interface comes with a sticker, which is pretty cool. I didn't expect that in the purchase. Here is my USB to HDMI. It's very basic. It's an Amazon brand. It's only $5.99. Really good deal. And then I got three XLR to male to female cables, and $5.99 for each. Not a bad deal. They came in these boxes right here. I threw away the one this came in because it was such a small box. There was no way in hell I was getting that back in that box. This is your audio interface, if I can get it out. This is your Behringer Uphoria UM2. As you can see, you got the XLR, got some inserts for headphones, instrumental inserts. This is the back for speakers to connect to your laptop. On the website it actually says, no, not this, it says that the Neewer does not work with a Mac, but we have a MacBook Air, I believe 13, and it works perfectly fine with it. I have not had any problems. At first I did, but you have to go to your settings and turn on the output and choose, and it should be right there. I was kind of fooled by the products because they both came with XLR cables and the USB to HDMI connector, but I got extras, so it's not a big deal because cables break really easily. The microphone comes with a clamp in this little baggie. Some of the bags are kind of a pain to take everything in and out of. Kind of a small clamp for areas like this. It barely fits almost. So this particular table, which is about that thickness, as you can see, it barely fits onto it. So if you have a table that's any thicker than this, you're going to definitely probably need a new clamp that is outside of this set. The pop filter is kind of flimsy for attaching it to the microphone stand. I didn't find a very good way to do it. I didn't trust it at all. It's a little bit thick for your normal pop filter, actually. For me, it kind of made my voice sound a bit drowned out and quieter, actually. That same goes with the wind muff, which I know is used to, you know, protect the wind, obviously, but I tried it out once and it actually made my voice a lot more quiet than I thought it would. So that's not very good. You got your nice microphone stand. I don't know if it's universal, but it fits this one pretty tight. So, which brings us to the microphone, which actually is a pretty thick microphone. So if you're getting any stands or anything, and they say that they're universal, I might not trust this one with that type of stuff. Neewer, there was some bad reviews on Amazon, but I, like I said, $32 for everything in this box, so I tried it out. Definitely not bad. So I tried it out, and I haven't had any problems with it so far. I truly would suggest all of this if you're starting out like I am. One of the things that I did not know that was on this Behringer right here was when you plug it into the computer, you had to click direct monitor, because I didn't do any research about how to record or anything. This is my first time even being around recording stuff, and I was kind of training myself how to do it. It's pretty basic, actually. I was worried that I wasn't going to figure out how to do it and that it was going to be a waste of money, but it's really basic, really easy. I guess I'll just post this video, and if anyone comments and asks any questions, I'll consider making a tutorial. Alright, that's it. Thank you. Subscribe.